Well, what are you going to do about it?
About what?
You know perfectly well what I'm talking about. Margot Gaffney.
Oh, that. Well, what'd you expect me to say? You behaved like a real crim. Congratulations.
Don't need your congratulations or anybody else's. Of course, I behaved perfectly. What do you expect?
Yeah, sure.
Point is, I shouldn't have to do these things. I mean, they should be taken care of for me.
Listen, what are you on about?
I'm asking why you didn't defend me.
Well, why should I?
Because it's your responsibility to protect me.
Protect you? You need about as much protection as a till of a Hun.
That's not the point. Of course I can look after myself. These morons are no match for me. Just I shouldn't have to.
You really expect me to do it, don't you?
Of course, that's what you're here for.
What makes you think you're so important?
Well, that should be obvious. Now, I know the women listen to you. I have enemies. But it's your duty to keep them away from me. Now, I know anyone can make a mistake, so I'll overlook the incident this time, but it mustn't happen again. You mustn't ever forget that your most important function in life is to protect me.
And what, may I ask, do you think you're doing?
What does it look like? I'm having a rest.
You're supposed to be cleaning. Now get out there and do it.
Don't be ridiculous.
As long as you are in here, Peterson, you will do as you are told.
Honestly, you really don't see me as a cleaning lady, do you? I mean, the whole idea is preposterous.
Get out in that corridor. I want the floor mopped.
Did you do that when you were inside?
Move it.
Of course, we're not of the same caliber, are we? I expect you did everything you were told, no matter how demeaning. Clean the toilets, peel potatoes.
All right, that's it. You're going to the governor's office now.
Does your future husband know the fact that his wife made herself a lackey while she was in prison? Oh, I see. You haven't told him. Oh, well, he seems to have a sense of humour. Perhaps he'll see the funny side when I tell him.
Get off that bed now.
Oh, just now, thank you. I'm feeling rather tired. You can tell Mrs. Davidson. I'll see her later.
Well, that's mad. Why should a qualified doctor waste her time scrubbing floors?
Exactly. I should be using my talents, not wasting them.
I would have thought they could have used a bit of extra medical help around here. There's no staff doctor, is there?
All right, smart. What do you think you're doing?
Nothing, Mrs. Powell.
Exactly. Now get on with that cleaning. And speed it up. Right, Peterson. Now, what's all the trouble about?
There's no trouble.
You refuse to do your assigned work?
Of course.
You're coming to the governor's office now, and I don't want any trouble.
That's all right. I'm not feeling tired anymore. I'll be glad to accompany you. Shall we go?
And then she refused Officer Conway's direct order to report to you.
All right, pal, that'll be enough for now.
I will not tolerate insubordination, Peterson.
Of course not. I quite understand that. It must be very difficult for you trying to run this place and having to put up with types like Powell.
That's enough.
Will you be quiet? You really must learn not to interrupt. Of course, I understand your problems, Mrs. Davidson. It's never easy dealing with subordinates. Although, of course, I do realize that these menials are necessary for running a place of this type.
Menials?
Silence! You know, I was thinking while I was having my rest this afternoon, you could do with some help to keep the women in line, not to mention the people who are helping you. So I've decided to help you. As a matter of fact, I find the idea of a joint venture rather challenging.
I don't know what you're playing at, Peterson, but it won't work. Now, I've heard enough of your nonsense, and I demand an apology to Mrs. Powell.
An apology?
You are in enough trouble already. Don't make things worse for yourself.
Oh, I see. You have to say these things. You feel you can't accept my offer of help in front of the staff. I think you should, you know. People get quite uncomfortable if they sense that things are being kept from them. Yes? What is it?
Well, ladies, I understand the paper's just about ready.
Yeah, we're just waiting for you, Mrs. Davidson.
Let's not wait any longer, then.
Okay. Hey.
Hot off the press, huh? Oh, okay. The compliments of the staff of the Weekly Star, Mrs.
Thank
Davidson.
You.
One for you, sir. Brenda? Okay.
What the hell is going on?
Lizzie, I think you blew it.
Oh, Lizzie, what's all this about? What are you up to?
What do you mean? Your story looks real good, Jude.
It's upside down.
Huh? Oh, so it is. Must have set the plates wrong again.
Hi. I guess you haven't heard Marnie's coming back for a while to help out with the paper.
That should keep the morons happy. Personally, I think it's a waste of time.
Oh, I don't know. There's a lot to be said for getting a chance to tell our stories. I take Judy Bryant. She can bring out the whole episode with Jock Stewart. And Susie. Well, it's really dreadful that a girl like that's in here.
I suppose it has its good points.
What about you? I'll bet your story'd be the most interesting of all. A woman like you, intelligent, from a good environment, connections, class, all that. Must have been hard for you to adjust.
You know, you're right. The hardest thing was trying to adjust to people with such different backgrounds from mine. Of course, I was friendly at first, but they just seemed to see me as prey. I suppose I was so different. They seemed to consider my intelligence some sort of threat.
Did they give you a lot of trouble?
They tried, but they soon realized that tangling with me was a fatal mistake.
I read about your case outside.
Murder, they called it. I just fiddled a little from people with money. It was for my son, for his education. And Conrad decided to turn me in. After all I did for him. I'm a child. Children are such a drain on your life. I'm never going to have any.
But you had a son.
The money was for him. Then that Edwards woman was going to go and tell the police. I had to stop her. Any mother would have done the same thing. She was going to ruin my son's life. So I got rid of him.
Him? You were just talking about a woman, Sandy Edwards.
He was threatening me. Oh, the boy didn't matter, but I was in danger, so one day I just put him in the rubbish compactor. Right over there, that's where I did it. Now he's gone. See, she really didn't know who she was up against. You do understand, don't you?
Yeah.
She was going to kill me. And Bea and Judy. There's danger everywhere. So I have to take care of them.
Come on, you two. Time to go back in.
Work beneath you, Peterson.
Just a minute.
I suppose you know O'Brien wants a transfer.
Yes.
Look, I don't know what you're trying to pull, but it's not going to work. God, you're nothing but trouble. What have you done to Bryant?
Why, nothing. She shouldn't be moving. She's supposed to be protecting me. I mean, I have enemies everywhere. I'm in constant danger. It's her duty to protect me. It's not a bad little act.
So you want everyone to think you're mad? Well, you're not fooling me, so just drop it.
You know, I really ought to start eating elsewhere. I mean, they could be getting at the food. Poison's so easy.
You should know. Go on, get off to the loading bay and no more trouble. Understood?
Yes. Yes, of course.